In this video, we want to look at what's called receptor adaptation. And what this means is that receptors, or pathways processing sensory information, often have the ability to diminish their responsiveness in the presence of a continuous stimulus. Right? In other words, they stop responding or respond less to a stimulus, even though that stimulus remains present. And you might ask, why would you want to do that? Well, there are a couple of reasons. One is that it's energetically expensive to continuously respond to a stimulus. Another is that sometimes continuously responding to a stimulus just doesn't make a lot of sense. Right? We don't need to know when things aren't changing. For instance, you put your clothes on in the morning and you feel your shirt slide on, right? It's important to know that, you know, they be receptive to that information. But do we need to be reminded continuously all day long that we have a shirt on? Well, maybe when we move, but not continuously, right? And so we want to be informed of changes in a stimulus, but not necessarily always be informed of that stimulus continuously. Now, there are two primary different versions of this receptor adaptation. One is where during the presence of a continual stimulus, right? So our stimulus comes on here and goes off over here, right? In complete adaptation, we get a stimulus response in the receptor, and it ceases even though the stimulus continues. And then when the stimulus disappears, stimulus goes away, we actually fire another action potential or a couple of action potentials. And what that means is it's very distinctly delineating the beginning and the end of the stimulus, not necessarily telling us all about it during the stimulus itself. Now, in incomplete adaptation, what happens is we respond to the stimulus, but then we respond less over time. So again, energy saving, but now we're going to be receiving information about that particular stimulus throughout the duration of it. Now, often this occurs through what's called membrane adaptation. In other words, the receptor itself becomes less sensitive to the stimulus over time. In other words, the receptor potential will get smaller. This is usually due to increased potassium efflux and the receptor itself becoming slightly hyperpolarized. Now, this complete and incomplete adaptation, another name for these is phasic, right, when we get complete adaptation, or tonic, when we get incomplete adaptation and continue to respond. Sometimes, oftentimes, these terms are kind of confused with fast and slow, and we don't want to do that. We want to make sure that we understand that phasic receptors can be fast or slow, right? We've got fast on the left here and slow on the right. In the slower scenario, we still shut off entirely, right? We cease to respond over here, but it takes longer to do so. And then in incomplete adaptation, often incorrectly identified as slow, right? We can have fast or slow. In fast, we shift to reduced receptor activity more quickly. And in slow, it takes a little bit longer for that to occur.